Hey, how you doing? It's Teacher Will, and I'm back with another video. And this video, I kind of like. Why? Because it talks about two very important words while learning English. Fluency and accent. So, what is fluency? Think about it this way. Fluency is the ability to understand English the same way that you understand your native language. Arabic, Spanish, Tagalog, for example. Now, fluency, I'll be honest with you, it takes a long time, all right? So being fluent or having fluency in English takes time and practice, but when you do it, you'll be able to understand formal English, informal English, slang English, and nuance. Nuance is really important. Nuance, I define as being able to choose the right word or say the right word given the particular emotion or expression that you want to say. So that's fluency, understanding the language the same way that you understand your native language. Now, what is accent? Well, when you think about accent, think about pronouncing or pronunciation, how you say words. And pronunciation is shaped by a lot of factors. One factor, for example, is where you might live. So, fluency or accent. Now, accent is interesting because with an accent, you can kind of do a drill down or divisions of accent. What do I mean by that? Stress. When you're learning accent, stress is where you put the particular focus on the word. Like if I say William, so I'm stressing the William, for example. So stress is part of accent. The other part of accent is intonation. Intonation thinks, or when you think of intonation, think about the raising and lowering of your voice. Am I speaking monotone like this? That is not an example of an intonation. So intonation is the rising of your voice when you speak and you learn English. And the last is rhythm. Rhythm, when you're thinking about the rhythm of English, think about how flow, think about movement. So those are the aspects of accent, stress, intonation, and rhythm. So here's what I think. When you're learning English and you have to make a decision or a choice, what Teacher Will believes is becoming fluent and having fluency is much more important in the beginning than having accent. What do I mean by that? Well, wouldn't you want to understand what someone is saying to you beside the way that they say it? So understand first fluency and then develop the accent. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, listen, I'm a native English speaker. And even us, native English speaking countries, for example, the United States or New Zealand or Australia, we all have different accents. But the base or the root or the fluency comes from English. Now, we might say different words or pronounce different words differently, but that is accent. So, here's my final thought and suggestion. When you are learning English for the very first time, focus on fluency, focus on understanding. And if you want to sound like a native English speaker, there are many different ways that you can do that. And I'll talk about that later on another video. So, focus on fluency, understand what people are saying to you. First fluency, then accent. So let me know what you think about the video. Make a comment below. Let me know if you agree or disagree. Fluency versus accent. What's more important to you?